Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, now we are going to talk about a new topic, that is law of mass action. So what is law of mass action and how does it play a very vital role in determining the rate constant as well as the equilibrium constant? So let us talk about it. So now let us understand what is law of mass action. So according to the law of mass action, the law of mass action states that the rate of a chemical reaction is directly proportional to the product of the active masses of the reactants, with each active masses term raised to a power equal to its respective stoichiometric coefficient in a balanced equation at that given temperature. It is very simple to understand. So let me give you an example so that we could understand what is actually law of mass action, and then we can talk about that how it is very much important. So suppose if we have a reaction, just a general reaction, if I am representing in this way, that is if A moles of A is reacting with suppose B moles of B so as to give a particular product. So in this case, where the small a is what it represents and the B, it represents a stoichiometric coefficient of A and this one, A and B respectively. So, or we could also call it as number of moles of A and number of moles of B. So therefore, if we give the statement according to the law of mass action, and according to that law, it states that the rate of the reaction is dependent on the concentration of the reactant. So therefore, we could represent the concentration of the reactant A as, so this is the representation where we represent the concentration of the reactant A, and similarly we could also mention the concentration of reactant B. So we have got to know that the rate of the reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of the reactant. Means if the concentration of the reactant is more, then we could say that the rate of the reaction will also be more. And that's the reason that according to the law of mass action, we could give a statement that is the rate of the reaction represented by rate is directly proportional to the concentration of the reactant, that is A and B. We write it in this way. But talking about the power, yes, it has also mentioned that with each active mass is a term raised to a power equal to its respective stoichiometric coefficient. But if you observe, that is the concentration of that is A, and in this case that how many moles or what is the stoichiometric coefficient in this case is small a. So therefore, according to the law of mass action, we should write, that is we should represent in this way, where concentration of A raised to A and concentration of B raised to B. So this is what it tells about the law of mass action. So but if we can evaluate more also in this case, so suppose if I am representing in this way, where the rate of the reaction is directly proportional to the product of the concentration of the reactant raised to their respective stoichiometric coefficient. But because of the proportionality sign has been there, so if I equate it in the form of, so as to get a particular constant value, so therefore the constant value that I could get is, suppose it is K. So that is the reason that we could write the further part as A raised to A and B raised to B. So this is nothing but the rate of the reaction depending on the, that is the law of mass action, and that what we have written it for the above equation, and as well as we have got a particular that is rate constant as K. So that is the reason the law of mass action, it tells a detail about the concentration, how the concentration of the reactant is basically very much responsible for the rate of the reaction, and along with that we have got a constant value that is known as rate constant. So this was nothing but a short synopsis of what is law of mass action. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video, and you have got to know that what is actually law of mass action. And I hope you'll share this video with your friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.